Welcome to Food Tech Mitra. In today's video, we are going to see about humidity and its types, that is absolute, specific and relative humidity. We know that water exists in three different states of matter and we call it as water vapor when it is in gaseous state. Humidity is a very general term and it is the amount of water vapor present in air. If you take a sample of air, it holds some amount of moisture or water vapor in it. We call a condition called high humid or more humidity when the air holds more amount of moisture or water vapor with it. Similarly, when it holds less amount of water vapor, the condition is called as low humid. For your easy understanding, let us see some examples on humidity conditions from our day-to-day life. At a high humid condition, the air is saturated with water vapor, which avoid the sweat to evaporate from our body. Instead, it just cling to the surface of the skin, which makes it more uncomfortable during high humid condition. At low humid condition, the outside air contains less amount of water vapor, so sweat will be evaporated and you feel dry and more comfortable. Very low humidity will make you feel cooler than the actual temperature. This is because the dry air helps to evaporate sweat more quickly than usual. Absolute humidity. Absolute humidity is the measure of water vapor in the air regardless of temperature, and it varies with time and place. Hence, absolute humidity is not used in most of the calculation. Absolute humidity is equal to mass of water vapor divided by volume of air and water vapor mixture. Specific humidity. Specific humidity is another way to express humidity and it is also referred as humidity ratio. And specific humidity is given as the ratio of mass of water vapor to the total mass of air and water vapor mixture. And it does not vary with pressure or temperature as long as the moisture is not added or removed from it. Relative humidity. Relative humidity is a useful measure of humidity. The term relative means in relation to another term. Okay, in very simpler terms, it is the ratio between the actual quantity of water vapor present in the air at a given temperature and the maximum quantity of water vapor that the atmosphere can hold at that temperature. So relative humidity is given as the partial pressure of water vapor divided by theoretical saturated water vapor pressure into 100. Okay, and the amount of water vapor that can be contained in the air increases with temperature, and the higher the percentage of relative humidity, the moisture you feel, while a lower percentage of relative humidity means you feel drier. Saturation occurs when air is holding the maximum amount of water vapor possible at that existing pressure and temperature. And saturation is equal to 100% relative humidity resulting in precipitation. And it is expressed in percentage. How relative humidity varies with temperature? For your better understanding, let us assume a block of air. Okay. So, as I already told, relative humidity varies with temperature and pressure. Okay, as we are having more or less atmospheric pressure, we will ignore pressure and take temperature. So let us consider the block of air with 100% relative humidity, which means the whole block of air is saturated. Okay, so imagine this air block is heated slightly. Okay, air expands and spreads out and fills out larger space. As you all know, warm air holds more moisture. In this case, the block of air can hold more amount of moisture, but it contains only 3/4 of the block. Okay, so this is the water vapor and this is the air portion. So we have heated the air, so the air gets expanded, but it contains only 3/4 of the water vapor when compared to the full air block. So the relative humidity is 75%. Similarly, when the block of air with 75% is relative humidity is heated further, it expands further and create little more larger space. Now, okay, so this is the whole block of air and the presence of moisture is only half of the block. So in that case, the relative humidity is 50%. So similarly, on further heating, the relative humidity value decreases. That is, the block of air get expanded on further heating. So the relative humidity value decreases. Okay. Hope you understand the various humidity terminologies.
Thanks for watching my channel. If you like the video, kindly comment and share with your friends and don't forget to subscribe.